Eddie Murphy and most of the old gang return in the fourth edition of the Beverly Hills Cop franchise. Our review, Axel F, coming up on Mikeylito's Matinée. Hello again, everybody. 2 days late, but I've been enjoying my Independence Day holiday, and I hope you have been too. My name is Mikeylito, and just like many of you, I'm just an average movie guy using my Regal Unlimited subscription and watching a movie in theater every week and telling you what I think about it. Before I tell you about this week's movie, for which I didn't have to leave the house, let me ask you to please like and subscribe to the channel. Click that bell and select all so that you don't miss any of the videos on the stream. Subscribe to MikeylitoLIVE on X for any late breaking updates about the channel content. And you can also check the community tab right here on YouTube. Our movie this week is Beverly Hills Cop Axel F, which is currently streaming on Netflix and has Eddie Murphy returning as Axel Foley, the Detroit detective who occasionally ventures into Beverly Hills, California, because life isn't exciting enough in the Southland. As sequels go, they tend to be formulaic, and this one is no different. Our story begins with Foley and a partner trying to solve the theft of the possessions of the Detroit Red Wing. As usual, much property is destroyed, and the powers that be in the police department want ahead. And Axel's old partner and deputy chief, Jeffrey Freeman, played by Paul Reiser, decides to give the department his own head. Meanwhile, out in Beverly Hills, Axel's daughter, Jane Saunders, played by Taylor Page, is being helped by our old friend, Judge Reinhold's Billy Rosewood. Jane, a lawyer, and Billy, now a private investigator, are defending a young man accused of killing a cop. However, they've obtained evidence that that just isn't true, and Jane is threatened to quit the case. Billy, against Jane's wishes, calls Axel to let him know. Axel flies to L.A., and we're giving various touch tones that we've seen in earlier Beverly Hills Cop movies. Axel, whilst searching for Billy, who has been kidnapped and has disappeared, gets involved in a chase through Beverly Hills, gets arrested, and he meets Detective Bobby Abbott, played by someone I've enjoyed watching ever since his early days on Third Rock from the Sun, Joseph Gordon-Levitt. We also revisit Detective John Taggart, played by John Ashton, who's now chief of the Beverly Hills Police Department. We also revisit Detective John Taggart, played by John Ashton, who's now chief of the Beverly Hills Police Department. Everybody's bacon number is reduced to one when Taggart introduces Foley to an old friend, Captain Cade Grant, who has that interdepartmental job that Billy had in Beverly Hills Cop 3. Yes, Grant is played by Kevin Bacon. Axel notices that Grant's attire outstrips what a public servant would wear and gets suspicious. Jane bails out Axel and tells him to leave town, but Axel continues his search for Billy by hooking up with Bobby and Axel's old friend, Serge, with Bronson Pinchot returning as the character. But the important thing is that there are many moments in this film, like this callback moment with character actor Luis Guzman, somewhat of a callback, not exactly, but somewhat of a callback to the strip club moment in the first Beverly Hills Cop movie. There are camaraderie moments like this one and this one and even this one. And there are heartfelt moments like this one that shows up late in the film and just blew me away. Beverly Hills Cop Axel F is not a great film. There may be some quibble whether or not it's even a good film. I can guarantee you this. It's miles and miles better than Beverly Hills Cop number 3. Producers Eddie Murphy and Jerry Bruckheimer have let it be known that Beverly Hills Cop 5 is in development. However, it wouldn't be a bad thing if this fourth film were the last. Here's the 10-point scoring scale from Track TV that I use to grade content. I'm giving Beverly Hills Cop, Axel F, a 6 out of 10. That's equivalent to 3 stars on a 5-star scale. Why the producers used Lauren Balfe instead of Harold Faltermeyer to score the film, I couldn't tell you, because throughout most of the film, Faltermeyer's themes were used. Director Mark Molloy made his feature film directorial debut with this film, which for the most part is okay, although I had big problems with a set piece that's used later in the film. Axel F is rated R by the Motion Picture Association for language throughout, violence, and brief drug use. The movie is streaming right now on Netflix. There are no ticket takers or ushers, so it's up to parents to patrol whether their kids are watching or not. Should you watch the film? I think you should, especially if Beverly Hills Cop 3 left a bad taste in your mouth. And as I always say, watch content, form opinion. You just heard mine. I'd like to hear yours. Let's quickly run through what's coming up the next few weeks. Next Friday, Fly Me to the Moon with Scarlett Johansson and Channing Tatum premieres. In 2 weeks, the highly anticipated by me, Twisters, premieres. In 3 weeks, the only film of the Marvel Cinematic Universe, the screen in 2024, Deadpool and Wolverine premieres. I'll do a special Live After Midnight for review and spoiler discussion of that film. And in August, another film I'm really looking forward to, especially since Ridley Scott has given his approval. Freddy Alvarez's Alien Romulus premieres Friday, August 16th, and I'm all in for that. Thanks for watching. I apologize for being 2 days late with this review. However, I thought the film was benign enough that I was enjoying my Independence Day holiday that I thought it was safe for you to see without my opinion. But if you haven't seen it, you should see it. You should also comment down below on what you thought of this movie, this review, and all the reviews on the channel. Like and share this video, and please subscribe to the channel and tell all your friends. You can find me on these social media networks, and you can read my leisure blog at MikeylitoLIVE. And my opinion blog at MikeylitoLIVE.com. Until next Friday, when we'll review Fly Me to the Moon, I'm MikeylitoLIVE. Good luck. Stay safe. Be well. And until next time, ciao for now.